Hello and welcome to another episode of the 11th OVC examining primary resources. Primary resources, if you'll remember from the last couple episodes, are an item or object or individual that provides first-hand accounts of an event or time period and are considered to be authoritative. And today, for this week, we're going to be examining government resources. So this is going to include all sorts of documents and publications, including laws, bills, census records, and in the case of this week, we're going to be looking at military regulations. So I have a copy of the Uniform and Dress Regulations of the Army of the United States, circa 1861, and this is through the authority of the War Department, and we're going to be looking at an excerpt describing what the mounted jackets looks like as described in the records here. So it says, all enlisted men of the Dragoons, Cavalry, Mounted Riflemen, and Light Artillery shall wear a uniform jacket of dark blue cloth with one row of 12 small buttons on the breast placed at equal distances, stand-up collar to rise no higher than to permit the chin to turn freely over it, to hook in front at the bottom, and to slope the same as the coat collar. On the collar, on each side, two blind buttonholes of lace, 3/8 inch wide, one small button on the buttonhole, lower buttonhole extending back 4 inches, upper buttonhole 3.5 inches. Top button and front ends of collar bound with lace 3/8 inch wide and a strip of the same extending down the front and around the whole lower edge of the jacket. The back seam laced with the same and on the cuff a point of the same shape as on the coat, but formed of the lace, jacket to extend to the waist and to be lined with white flannel. Two small buttons at the underseam of the cuff, as on the coat cuff. One hook and eye at the bottom of the collar. Collar of lace, worsted, orange for dragoons, yellow for cavalry, green for riflemen, and scarlet for light artillery. And so I have some other documents in the form of special orders and general orders of various regiments during the Civil War, kind of addressing some of the issues in what soldiers were doing or to these described jackets that were supposed to be regulation. And so here we have an example. This is Regimental Order Number 25 of the 9th Michigan Cavalry. This was May 12, 1863. And it says, the commanding officer notices that it is becoming a general custom for the non-commissioned officers and privates to rip off the braid on their uniform jackets, thereby defacing and otherwise mutilating them. Such practices are positively forbidden. Officers will see that it is immediately replaced. Another example, Special Order number 65 from the headquarters of the 9th Pennsylvania Veteran Cavalry near Whiteside, Tennessee. This is October 11, 1864. No enlisted man will be allowed to disfigure his uniform jacket by tearing off the regulation stripes, and for such offense will be stopped 1 month's pay, and if a non-commissioned officer, reduced to the ranks. A third example is the Department of West Virginia, headquarters of the 2nd Cavalry Brigade, or 2nd Brigade Cavalry Division, Martinsburg, March 23rd, 1864. And it says, the stripping of braid from the dress jacket is expressly forbidden there. So it's kind of neat to see that some of the guys in the field were actively modifying those coats, and it's neat to actually get primary resources where they described this was occurring, and it's directly from that source. It's the military, it's the government there in those special orders and various forms of paperwork that they so often do. But it also supports the regulations that were stated in 1861. That's how that jacket is supposed to look. So it's two unique sources that kind of tell the same story there, but also a new story of what some things were done to modify there. So one of the nice things about examining a resource like this is for those of us who tailor our own uniforms or are looking to get a really authentic impression as a reenactor, is you can actually look at these regulations and get details that maybe you're not necessarily going to find elsewhere. For example, the buttonhole placement is 3.5 inches in at the top and 4 inches at the bottom and so forth. So you can learn lots of really neat details that you probably would not have been recorded otherwise. They would just say, yeah, we buttoned up our coats. So you know it has buttons, but not necessarily where they were. Just wanted to share that fun little thing with you. It's another joy combing through all these different sources and trying to locate all these little nuggets of information. And I hope you've enjoyed learning a little bit about what the guys were doing in the field with some of those mounted jackets. We'd like to thank you guys for joining us this week for another review of a primary resource. If you want to learn more about the 11th OVC and some of the other things we're doing, go ahead and subscribe, hit like, and hit the little bell icon so you get notifications of what's going on. And until we see you in the field or in the library, read hard.